For a long time, I was very shy and very insecure, and I never believed that I could be different. I never believed that I could be confident in front of other people, but I was wrong. And in this video, I'm going to break down how a shy person can become confident in themselves and their abilities to communicate, how I did it, and how you can do as well. That's what's coming up right now. Hi and welcome back to the Conscious Leaders TV. I'm Yannick Matzner, I'm your leadership and business coach. I'm the founder of the Conscious Leaders Mastermind. And here on this channel, I mentor you every single day to be a great leader and go after the life you truly want. But if you're not subscribed, you're not seeing my videos, and I can't mentor you. So go ahead, do it right now, and let's jump into this video. So first and foremost, we need to clear, what is the difference between being shy and being an introvert? So often those terms are intermixed, but they mean something very different. Someone who's shy is afraid of being embarrassed or failing. They're afraid of being seen by other people, and they're not confident in their ability to communicate. An introvert, on the other side, is just someone who recharges by being alone. That's all it means. And shyness is not a destiny. Introversion is not a destiny. And by the way, I don't believe that introvert or extrovert, that really exists. I think it is a label we put onto people so we can put them in a box. But that box does not need to define you. That's the first and foremost most important idea we need to understand. Shyness is not a destiny. Being an introvert is not a destiny. Being an extrovert isn't a destiny either. It is just a label. So in the first step that we need to do to become more confident, to express more of who we are, we need to let go of those labels because they are not serving us at all. So for a long time, I believed I am shy and insecure. And because I believe that, because I believe this is who I am, I acted accordingly. And you always get in life that of which you are. So when you act shy, when you think like you are shy, when you feel like, oh, I'm not good at this, well, you manifest more of it because you're doing everything to manifest more proof of who you are. So in life, our identity, our self-image determines everything. And the problem with that is the more proof we have, the more experiences we have which prove us right of what we believe we are, the more we believe we are this identity. So I had this one incident when I was 14 years old, and I did ask the first girl out on a date. And I thought it would be a great idea to write a love letter. So I thought that's how you do it, because frankly, none of my friends ever had a girlfriend. And I thought, like, that's how they do in the movies. So I'm just doing the same. And it went horribly wrong, like horribly wrong. And I got so badly rejected, and I felt so ashamed of that experience that I did close down. And the more I did close down, the more I did not speak up for myself, the more I wasn't bold in my life anymore, the more proof I gained that this is who I am. I am shy. I am insecure. I am unworthy of being loved. That was one thing I believed to be true about myself, and I proved myself wrong, right. I proved myself right over and over and over again because I created the same experiences. I watched movies all day. I played video games all day. And that is how I became shy and insecure. But before then, I wasn't. But we frame our past the way we see it. So if we see all that proof, and we let go of those things which are not really proving us right. So what we need to do is we need to reframe that past. We need to reframe that experience and let go of those labels. We need to see it as something that happened in our lives, but it doesn't need to define us. It doesn't need to define our future. So let go of those labels and then define a vision of you. Define a vision of you that you're striving towards. So when I wanted to change something about it, here's what I did. I decided I'm going to change myself because, frankly, I couldn't live with myself any longer. I didn't like this version of me of being shy and introverted because I didn't want to be that way. I wanted to be open. I wanted to have deep and intimate relationships in my life. And I realized those labels are not serving me at all. So I let go of those labels and I decided I'm going to be different. And I had this vision in mind of someone who's really charismatic, who's really open, who has the capability to communicate his own ideas. And I strove towards that vision all the time. And at first, of course, it was hard. At first, it was really tough to move outside your comfort zone. But as you do it more and more and more and more, being yourself becomes a habit. I mean, being not yourself, of closing down, of being shy, that is a habit in itself. You train yourself to be this way, but you can untrain yourself to be this way and train yourself to be different. So that's what I needed to do. And at first, I mean, it was scary as hell. And I made a commitment to myself to every single day go out and talk to one woman. I was terrified of speaking to women, especially because of those experiences I had. And it was terrifying to me at first. And I'd bail all the time. I mean, when you're trying to move beyond yourself, when you're trying to break the habit of being yourself, here's what's going to happen. A lot of the times you're going to bail. And that's totally fine. That's totally okay because you're moving closer and closer and closer to your edge. So I don't want you to judge yourself for sometimes not having the courage to go way beyond your comfort zone, because it's going to happen. And back then I did judge myself because I felt like, why can't you do this? Why can't you be more open? I judged myself for not being open, and it held me back. So what we need to do is we move beyond our comfort zone, but realize that we're not going to do it all the time. I mean, moving beyond your comfort zone is a habit in itself, and at first it will scare you like crazy. It will scare you like crazy. So it's important to keep in mind that the more you move closer towards your vision, the more you move closer towards your comfort zone, well, the more you train yourself to be your new version of you. But you don't need to be perfect. You don't need to face your fears all the time. So I did bail all the time. Like, for 6 months I was doing this, and like 99% of the time I really did bail. But I had that intention to go out. I did go out, and in the last second, before I was meeting someone, I bail. I turned the other way. That was my thing. But I moved closer and closer and closer and closer towards my fears. And at some point, they didn't scare me anymore. At some point, I felt like, if I'm going out and if I'm like doing this every day, why not meet actually someone? I mean, that was my thinking then, and it changed who I am. Doing this every single day changed who I am. So what I want you to do is pick one thing you can do every single day. And I mean every single day, to become different, to become who you want to be. And that changes your identity. It needs to be something that is scary. It needs to be something that is not normal to you, not natural to you, because everything that is natural to you right now created who you are right now. So in order for anything to change in your life, you need to change something what you do every single day. And the easiest way to change your identity, to change your self-image, is to act yourself into a new identity. I mean, it's really hard to change your thinking or your feeling like just one day. I mean, how do you control your thoughts if you're not doing anything differently? But if you're doing anything differently all the time, every single day, well, you train yourself to feel and think about yourself differently. That's what I do in these videos. I mean, 3 months ago, I decided to do one video per day because I knew it would change my identity. It would change my self-image. And now, as I've done this for 3 months, I mean, it is normal to me. It is normal and natural to do videos. And that's why I can speak extemporaneously into this lens, because it is normal to me. It is natural to me. I don't put it on a pedestal. So this is really vitally important to understand. We need to have a vision. We need to face our fears, go with what's not natural. And then what we need to do is, first and foremost, subscribe down below. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. Shameless plug right here. But what we then need to do is we need to stop putting other people on a pedestal. We need to stop putting them on a pedestal, because when we think they're better than us, when we think like we don't deserve to be around them, well, we're doing things which are not authentic to who we want to be. So I always wanted to fit in with other people. I'd always wanted to fit in with my cool classmates who are so much more charismatic, so much more confident, so much more open. And I felt like, well, who am I to belong to them? I'm a shy and insecure kid. And because I felt this way, they knew it too. They knew it too, and I put them on a pedestal. And I wanted to have a girlfriend, but I put all those women that I found attractive on a pedestal. I thought like, well, why would they choose me? Like, they have so many options, why would they choose me? But that's where self-love comes really in, because you need to love yourself unconditionally, even for your flaws, to really believe that you are worthy of being seen, to really believe that you are worthy of being loved. And that is so vitally important to understand, because self-love is really the key to your next level in life. So we need to appreciate our own flaws. We need to appreciate and accept them as who we are right now, knowing that we want to be better in the future, but also knowing that I'm good either way. Nobody, and I mean nobody, including yourself, can devalue you. It is only your own choice to devalue yourself. But if you put yourself back on that pedestal, if you see yourself as equal to them, well, those people are more likely to come into your life, because you don't have that neediness. I mean, haven't you seen someone who, for example, hadn't had sex like in 3 months or a year or 2 years? Like, I didn't have sex until I was 21 years old. And I put sex on such a whole, like, high pedestal that I couldn't even imagine having sex, because I just needed it. I had this neediness energy around me, and people can feel that. And because you are chasing something that you think you don't deserve, that you feel like you're not worth, well, it implies that the other person or the other thing, that whatever you want, is running. So when you're chasing love, when you're chasing money, when you're chasing like being more open, it implies that the other thing is running away from you. So when you stop chasing, when you stop that neediness energy, and when we just start being ourselves, when you just start making it completely natural to what we want to have in our lives, not overnight, but over time, well, that's when we get real results, and how people see us completely shifts. So for example, today nobody questions that I'm confident. Nobody questions that I like being myself, that I'm fully authentic. But before then, before I trained myself to be this well, things were very different. And I didn't get respect from other people because I wasn't being myself. So we need to start loving ourselves. We need to accept our flaws and weaknesses. And that's really the point of like moving outside your comfort zone. As you do it over and over and over and over and over again, you just accept that it is part of who you are. You make it natural to you. And as soon as you make something natural to you, you attract more of that into your life. So as soon as you make it natural to take, like, to talk to women on the street or to talk to strangers or whatever you want to do, as soon as you make that natural, as soon as you stop putting it on a pedestal, that's when your results really start to come in. And that's why men, for example, that I looked up to, they had amazing dating results, simply because it was natural to them. They didn't put it on a pedestal. They didn't put those women on a pedestal, and that's why they did get the results they wanted to have. They didn't put it on a pedestal. They didn't make it bigger than it was, and it was completely natural to them. You can train yourself to see whatever you want to do in your life in the same way, by changing your own self-image. As soon as you see yourself as deserving of having what you want, you start getting what you want. So this is critically important to understand. We need to change our identity. And then lastly, but not leastly, is that a word? We need to develop confidence. I mean, the more you move outside your comfort zone, the more you're going to develop confidence. But confidence can be a tricky thing, like what is confidence? But there's a real simple formula for developing confidence. So confidence is made up of the five C's. The five C's. Number one, congruence. The more authentic you are being yourself, the more you are in alignment with who you are meant to be, with who you think you should be, the more confident you are. So for a long time, I did not feel confident at all, simply because I was betraying my own potential, because I wasn't living up to my own potential. And that's, I always felt that separation between me and my best self. I knew I wasn't living my best life. So you need to choose to live your best life, live in alignment with who you know you want to be. Not being perfect, but striving to be there, to get there. And that's when real confidence kicks in. So it's congruence. This competency, and this is really vitally important for someone who's shy or introverted and doesn't like to be around other people. I mean, if you don't like to communicate to other people, it's because you've told yourself the story that you're not good at it. So I told myself the story that I'm not good at it, and because I had the story in my mind, I wasn't becoming a better communicator. So the moment you start to focus on developing your competencies instead of worrying about what other people think of you is the moment when confidence really starts to kick in. So what I had to do is I had to change my self-image, of course. I had to change my identity, seeing it as a natural, but I also had to develop my competencies. I had to develop my communication skills. I needed to really learn. This is how you share yourself most authentically, most vulnerable. This is how you unlearn everything that you've been taught. I mean, if you want to be more confident, learn how to develop more competencies. This is so critically important in our lives. Our competencies really determine how confident we are, because confidence is context dependent. It is not the same for every situation. So for example, in my own life, I was very terrified of speaking to women or other people in general, because I was afraid of their own judgment, of their, like, of embarrassing myself. But at the same time, in the same age, I was the same kind of person. I was playing soccer all the time and I loved it. And I was super confident on the soccer court, but I wasn't around other people. But on the soccer court, I was so confident. It was a completely different game. It seemed like I was a completely different person. And it was possible because your personality is context dependent. It is context dependent. It is not fixed. It is, like, highly dependent on your own environment. So one way you can change how you feel about yourself is, one, change your environment. So when you are in the same environment that brings out the same of who you are all the time, well, chances are it's pretty hard to change, because those people that you're around, they have an image of you and they are telling you, wait a minute, you're trying to act confident now? You're trying to be your most authentic self? You're trying to express who you are? Who the hell are you? I thought you were different. That's what they say. That's why environment is so vitally important. But then also those situations that you're putting yourself in, that context that you're putting yourself in, they shape who you become. So I shaped the context. I was putting myself in the shoes of someone who would talk to women every single day. That was a different context, and it needed a different personality. And at first, it didn't feel natural. At first, I didn't like it. But as you do it over and over again, as you change the context, you change your personality, you develop a different sense of who you are, and you change your self-image. This is so vitally important to understand if you want to be more confident as a shy person and develop those communication skills. So we have congruence, you have competency, and then we have connection. Connection. I mean, we as human beings, we are social beings. If we feel love in our lives, well, obviously we're going to be more confident, because we feel safe. We feel secure. I mean, in the ancient times, when someone didn't feel connection, it literally meant that they were, like, going to die. Like literally, because like they had no support, because they didn't belong to the tribe and they were left being alone. So we have this need for connection in our lives, but don't worry, because you have already some connections in your life. But what we need to do is we need to stop focusing on what we lack. So the lack of an intimate relationship, the lack of friends, and focus on what we do have, feeling grateful for what we do have in our lives. Like for example, I had loving parents. I had awesome siblings. I had some good friends. But what I had always done is focus on the lack of an intimate relationship, a lack of fitting in with the cool kids. That was what my focus was. And because I was focusing on what I was lacking, I didn't feed my confidence. I feeded my self-doubts because I felt like, well, I don't have those things. I don't deserve them. I don't feel worthy like having them. So we need to shift our focus, because we all have some loving people in our lives. I can assure you, maybe you have a parent that loves you. Maybe you have some siblings, some friends. I mean, maybe your partner. You have someone in your life who's supporting you, who's loving you. And if you've got nobody, then you've got me. I believe in you. And yeah, that's congruence, competency, connection. And those three are determined by two things: choices and courage. Choices and courage. Your everyday choices shape who you become. They shape your identity. So we need to make new choices to shape how we feel about ourselves, how we think about ourselves, how we see ourselves. So new choices, and we need courage. We need to step outside our comfort zone. That's the confidence formula. It's pretty simple: congruence, competency, connection, and then determined by courage and choices. Really simple. Start implementing. That's the power. The power is in the repetition. The more you do it, the more you believe, this is who I am. I am confident. I believe in myself. That's the real key to increasing your confidence, to become a confident person when you're shy or an introvert and you want to be different. But one last thing I want to leave you with, and then we're going to end this video, is don't see being an introvert as something that is negative. I don't see it as something that is like holding you back. See it as a gift. See it as something that is really serving you, because maybe you need to develop those communication skills. Maybe you need to face your fears to become more confident in front of other people, but you have some unique gifts because you are an introvert, because you are shy. Maybe you're a good listener. Maybe you can emphasize really good with other people. I mean, those are two of my biggest strengths. And I knew I needed to develop my weaknesses to become a well-rounded human being. But I also knew listening and empathy, so underrated, but so vitally important today. So don't see introversion or being shy as something that is negative. It is serving you, and now it's just about becoming a well-rounded human being, knowing that you are good either way. You're good where you are right now. You are worthy of love, of money, of whatever you want in your life. You are worthy to have everything that you want. Just make it natural to you. Make it natural to be who you are. Make it a habit, and I promise you, you're going to change your life. You're going to change how you see yourself. And that's the power of identity. I mean, your identity drives your entire life. Change your identity and you're going to change your life. And down below, there is the Reinvent Yourself Challenge, in which I'm going to show you literally in 5 days how to change your self-image, how to become confident, how to develop your skills, your competencies, and then how to change your energy and change your habits. I'm going to literally show you, walk you through how to change yourself, how to reinvent yourself. I highly recommend that you join it for free down below. It can change your life. And until the next time, make sure that you live fully, live openly, and be the leader of your life.